Ami Kaufman, this is going to be the hardest transition of my life. But Ami Kaufman is here daily with the web review, speaking of the banality of the internet.
Yeah, so, the evil of the internet.
The evil of the internet, speaking of the
virus. It's hard for you to think how it is for me. I mean, yeah, it's going to be
evil,
a tough one.
Yeah, the evil spiral. But before you continue, Hannah Arendt, the film is out everywhere.
Yes.
Go see it. Phenomenal. I want to thank you for being here. Yes.
I do see a little evil connection to this next viral video because it has to do with the Republican Party.
Ah.
That's just my personal politics.
Well, just, yeah. But, not taking a stance, yes.
This is a video that went totally viral, and the reason for this, I don't know who made it, but it's got already like over 10 million views. The man obviously had too much on his time. He took footage from a debate and put it on the music of a very famous rap song by, it's called Slim Shady. What I really want you to notice is he took the actual things that the Republican candidate said and made them rhyme.
And made them
on
rhyme.
On the beat.
Let's take a look.
Is there anyone on stage? Is there anyone on stage? Well, the rules for tonight shrink government. 30 seconds. Well, the rules for tonight shrink government. Without further ado, let's begin.
In Florida, they call me Jeb. I'm proud of my brother.
You are a criminal.
I've got a record in Florida. We've done it 27 times since World War II.
But he says you do nothing.
True, but I have said that Mr. Trump's earned legal status really mirrored what we said is ridiculous, tragic. I believe we can do this the right way and with low expectations, dumb down everything.
Brilliant.
No, brilliant.
It's a 5-minute video. The man obviously spent a year doing it. I don't know.
But
it's
like,
I don't know. It's just crazy. It's on beat, perfect rhyming, and it's hilarious.
And I think I would use that as a campaign if I were Jeb Bush.
Yes.
Yeah.
Here is another video. Of course, this one has to do with Donald Trump, and it has to do with the Star
Nothing
Wars movie.
Nothing banal about that.
Yeah, the Star Wars movie is coming out next week. The Force Awakens.
The Force Awakens.
And so
finally.
They said, let's take some old clips from Star Wars and put Donald Trump's voice into Darth Vader. And
yes.
The result is kind of funny. Let's
take a look.
If only you could be so bold.
The Imperial Senate will not sit still for this. When they hear you've attacked a...
How dare the press not believe me that I went after my mother with a hammer? He said he went after his mother... With a hammer, he wanted to hit her on the head.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then I tried to stab a friend of mine, but now it's changed.
I mean, the sad thing about this is you almost want Trump to get that as far as he did because it's going to give ground to so many amazing things as such.
Yes.
Yes.
But boy, is it scary. It is getting scary.
Very scary. Very scary.
Sticking with the Star Wars theme, of course, a lot of us have heard of Airbnb, which is how you get a great way to get a room and go on holiday.
A lot of us live the life that is Airbnb.
You might want to check out this new Airbnb concept. It's called Starbnb. It's for Star Wars, where you can actually choose a Star Wars themed accommodation. It's not real,
Tatooine.
Of course.
It's
a spoof, but it's obviously another
instance
of
another,
an example of a man who has too much time on his hands. And of course, we can see some of the pictures of these fake accommodation.
There's also dwelling.
And there are reviews of angry reviewers. Of course, we have bad reviews saying
the Death Star was nothing. I imagine
the bits where
okay, we've got that.
So that's Airbnb.
And.
A lot of women like to take their pictures on Instagram.